If there's one thing we need to discuss right now.
What?
It needs to be made clear to you and to everyone listening that chocolate mint as a combination is trash.
It's not trash. I dare say it is hard for chocolate to go poorly with anything.
It is so awful.
No, it's not.
It is such a bad combination.
It really isn't.
The taste of it, I would maybe rather eat like a little block of dirt than eat like an Andes mint.
You don't have after eights over here, do you?
Do I have what?
After eights. After eights.
After AIDS?
After eights. Oh, do you remember Asteroids? They were like kind of like pretzel M&Ms.
Oh no, that's not. Asteroids. That's a European deal.
Oh, okay. They were real good too. I mean,
how many chocolate mints did you get?
I only got two.
The thing.
How did it feel to share that moment? A real thing.
Oh, dude. Shoot, dude. I'll get emotional if I talk about that too much. To be able to have her there and hug her and tell her how much I love her and how much I couldn't have done this without her, it really means a lot to me.
They just asked, like, what was it like to share that moment with Becky and Gorilla? So I just told them the truth.
I was like, oh, should I get out of here? I don't know.
You should stay.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you.
No. You gotta challenge the champ face to face, man to man, as there is not a man in this company that's got the guts to challenge me face to face.
Is that so?
Oh, hey. Hey, I'm just a figure of speech, just saying, you know, no one's challenged me. Didn't mean anything by it, you know.
Challenge! Next on Up, Up, Down, Down.
Don't know what just happened.
Yes! Oh, so close to Becky Two Belts.
Oh my God.
So close to Becky Two Belts. God.
I don't know what's happening. We don't need to talk about me.
Well,
talk about that.
As you saw, well, there's a ritual.
Oh.
So the champion, when they lose the title, as you noticed when Joe did this for you, you have to get down on a knee and say very kind words about the new champion.
Who started this ritual?
I did.
Go on, get down on a knee again.
Here, let's go to the other room so we can have some more. Here you go.
Why don't we just stay here? Why don't we just stay here? We can stay right here.
Here we go.
I don't, I mean, I say every day, all I do is say nice things to you, so, congratulations on another first in your incredible career and in your life. I wish you all the best as the first female champion of Up, Up, Down, Down, and, hate losing. So I know. So it's time for me to go. Before I throw a tantrum.
I was the champ! Becky Two Belts is back! Becky Two Belts just made her return right here on Up, Up, Down, Down! Oh, I can't. Maybe I can't get through with this.
concerned about.
Okay, so let's see how well she did. The first question we asked Carmella was, what is Corey's biggest pet peeve about her?
Oh my God.
Am I gonna learn something?
There's so many. Let me.
Oh, never mind. Let me check.
Thought you might have been going the other way with it. So CG. Few.
I don't know.
Something.
I don't have any off the top of my head.
Come on, come on, give me
playing it safe. All right.
I like that.
Carmella, reveal. What did you say?
Can you get a little closer to bougie?
That's not really a pet peeve. That's just a character flaw.
All right, number two, we asked Carmella what her first impression was of you.
Ooh.
She thought I was handsome.
Hey, hot AF!
Ding, 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 ding,
ding, ding. CB.
He knows he's hot AF.
All right, number three, we asked her what the most embarrassing thing she has ever done in front of you.
Maybe when we were in London Airport and her top fell off in security.
No!
Wait, is that what you said?
No!
Which episode of Divas was this on?
I DVR
all of them.
Oh my God!
What did you put?
I just put, like, if I have bad grammar or, like, say something improper.
Did you spell grammar correctly?
I did.
Bad grammar.
What happened with this top falling off?
We were leaving London. She did not have her toiletries properly stored, and there was a bit of a panic in the security line. She had a tube top of some sort, bent down to fix her toiletries, and stood up and gave everyone in security quite the show.
Unbelievable. It's a tough job. I'm sure they enjoyed that.
Unbelievable.
All right, here we go. Corey, what do you think is Carmella's best physical feature?
Ooh.
Entering the danger zone.
I feel like you can't go wrong here, though.
Yeah, you're good.
No, I'm a fan of all of it. So that counts as points, right? Because I say all of it's great.
All inclusive.
Come on now, you got to pick one.
I'm a huge fan of her butt.
Oh! Hey!
Here we go.
Please do not hurt me when I ask you this question, Mr. Graves. Where is the weirdest place you guys have made whoopee? Location, please, in the physical world.
Oh my God. There's so many options.
We're in a different city every night.
Oh, that chocolate hat.
This show is the best.
Yeah. There was a particular shower that was quite fun.
It was waterfall effect with the colors. Yep.
There was like a bench.
Can we get the answer, please?
Carmella, show me that canoe.
What I did was I just went full Friends and I said foot of the bed because I couldn't.
I don't watch Friends.
Yeah.
That
nice.
Thank you.
Qu'est-ce que
tu fais? Je suis magnifique.
That's all wrong. It's not how you say it.
Je suis.
You sound like a cartoon. You sound like a cartoon. Like, it's like you need to be able to speak French. We've been together for 10 years. You don't speak French.
Je suis que tu m'as vu. Je m'appelle Mike.
That's it. That's
ça va?
No. Wait, you?
Ça va?
No.
That's non.
The way you say
pourquoi?
It. Pourquoi? You said pourquoi. You sound like you're Spanish pourquoi? Or like Italian. French is more like. Like.
No.
Like oui.
Oh, so that's why you're rude. No.
Guess what today is?
What is it?
You don't know what today is.
What's today?
It's our 3-year wedding anniversary.
Oh, what? Today?
That's right.
Oh.
And we are actually, it's really tomorrow, but we're celebrating it today. And we dropped the pups off here at my mom's because the SmackDown GM has to leave his pregnant wife. What are 3 things that you love about me?
Can I only name 3? Because I can name 100 things.
What a great husband. Yeah. So cute. Mm-hmm. No, he doesn't really have to name them because I hear him all day, every day. But I do a lot of times bother him and I'll say, what do I say to you? I will say put you on the spot for some stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
How much do you love me?
How much do you love me?
I say it to him a lot.
Yeah. But, and this is what I respond back, and it's always a different answer. But it's something like this. As many ants as there have ever been in the history of planet Earth, that's how much I love you.
He does always say the ants, which is a lot.
I don't always say the ants.
I feel like you do a lot, but I love it.
No, I gave them an example. I've said the ants once.
Oh. But I love it. And I love being married to this man. He's the most perfect husband in the world. I couldn't ask for a better husband. And soon to be father. So I'm so lucky. And I can't believe it's been 3 years. You know, our first year, our first wedding anniversary, I was overseas wrestling. And we didn't get to spend it together. But last year, we did. And we did a staycation, which was so fun. And then I'm excited that
we were both overseas wrestling.
Oh, we were.
Right?
You weren't injured?
That was
actually the big, yeah, that was the big injury.
That was my last tour.
That's
the
right.
The last tour of Daniel Bryan.
And you know what he did? I'm just going to brag about him really quick. But John and Nicole took me to dinner after the show. And all of a sudden, they pulled out this Tiffany's box. I was like, they got me a Tiffany's gift? And sure enough, Brian did, and it was a wooden bracelet from Tiffany's. It was the cutest thing ever. It's still my favorite bracelet. But it was so sweet.
And I also have massive triceps, which is what she loves about me.
I love everything about you. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
You know, I think when you are husband and wife and you're in a really strong, great marriage, you go through each other's ups and downs together. Brian's been through a lot of ups and downs with me, and I've been through all of his in the last 4 years. And from the moment Brian had to retire from in-ring performance, it really shook our house a bit. It was something hard to, like, for myself, to see your husband have his dreams taken away. Here, you sit on daddy real quick. It was really hard for me to see Brian's dreams get taken away. And I was kind of put in a place where it's like, okay, your doctors say one thing, and as a wife, you're concerned, and especially about his health, because I want Brian and I to grow old together, and you think about that. But at the same time, I looked at my husband, and you see an extremely healthy man, and very brilliant. And it was kind of weird, like, the signs didn't make sense to other signs, why they make people, you know, retire. And I know in Brian's speech, he kept thanking me, which was so cute, and it meant the world. I told him, I was, like, crying watching him, like, wait, what? No one's ever done that. And I was not expecting that. So you guys all know, don't think I'm a crazy wife, like, you better thank me. Brian, you killed it. You did so good. She was calling you Big Dad Dad. Big Dad Dad.
Uh-huh. It's a spousal war right now.
No.
My God.
Oh, no.
She was not accepting.
So we're here at the IGN Esports Showdown. And I think I've got a very interesting strategy. Yeah, I'm gonna come out and intimidate the hell out of everyone. But I've got a secret weapon. My wife. So, look. I'm not the best at fighting games, right? And I will try my hardest. But I'm pretty sure that Kofi Kingston is going to beat me. And that's okay, I've already accepted that. But I want him to think that it's so easy that he's like, and lets his guard down. And then I'm gonna let my wife come in and just annihilate him.
I'm about to marry my best friend. I'm about to marry the woman of my dreams. It's happening. We've been planning and talking and doing and organizing for over a year, and it's finally happening.
Our relationship started as strictly just a friendship for a long time. I was attracted to him, but I was also, he made me like a shy little schoolgirl, so I couldn't confess my feelings for him for a very long time. So we were just best friends for a while until I started trying to like you know, put my game on him.
She's everything. She's my best friend. She's my partner in crime. She's inspiration and motivation. She's the desire to be a better person, to be a better friend, to be a better man. She's my why. She's my reason. She's why I sacrifice, why I work hard, why I do the things I do, why I want a future. It's her. Without her, it doesn't make any sense.
I expect to cry a lot. I don't normally cry. I got teary-eyed earlier, and my dad freaked out because I, as a kid, I never cried. It's just, like, Ray's like the best person I know. So to be like worthy of being married to him and have his family accept me, it just fills me up. It really does. And I'm gonna remember how I felt today. And I think the families are gonna remember that too. So we'll all have this amazing, one of a kind bonding experience. And that also is exciting to me.
Today, it is to be established whether a binding of Raymond and Sarah is good and worthy. May the Aesir accept them. May they echo through the nine realms. Swear it to the ancestors.
I swear.
And swear it to the folk.
I swear.
I swear.
And you are husband and wife. Ah! Ah!
Our relationship has been the best thing in my life that's ever happened to me. So I've already felt like his wife, but you know, like you need this to happen. You need the wedding to happen, and you need like this to happen. And it was, I don't know, just my heart's full. My heart is full.
So good. You ready?
She ready, she ready, ready. Oh baby, she ready, ready, yeah, ready. Ready to rumble.
So we're on our way. What are we doing?
We're going to a trapeze school, which I'm really excited about / very eager / nervous.
I am clueless. I don't even know what.
Have you ever been on a trapeze?
No.
I don't know why that. I mean, it's not. I guess it's not usual. It'll be really
fun.
Yeah,
it's gonna be fun, and hopefully we get something good for you guys, and I just don't make a fool of myself.
We're just gonna be honest and be us, and like we may not be great at it, but we're gonna have fun, and hopefully you guys enjoy watching.
Yeah.
Person.
How are you gonna do it without me?
I was just gonna introduce everyone and then get to you and say,
I'm first.
We just got to the trapeze school.
Forward, back, forward, let's go, cover, cover.
Yeah! Did you see that? I almost left me hanging.
I
went for it. I know, but it's like, and then we fell, and I was just like, Killed
it, did a really good job.
That wasn't like a beginner's lesson, was
it? That is a beginner's lesson.
You did great. Thank you. Just had tears in my eyes, like, even now. Sorry. You did great. Sorry.
Thank you. Come here. I couldn't have done it without you.
You're awesome.
Thank you.
You're awesome. My heart was like beating faster than it's ever like in like for one of my matches. Like I was so stoked. Mm. And like I know like your numbers come in. My heart was just beating. Oh, it was amazing.
I couldn't have done it without you.
No, you definitely would have. Could have.
No. I wouldn't have liked it as much.
Superstar. She killed it. She's awesome. Just made her debut in 50,000 people, Royal Rumble. Killed it. She did awesome. It meant so, like, because I just know, like, how hard she wanted it and how hard she's been working. I've seen it since day one. And, I mean, it meant the world that she just went out there and showed everybody that it doesn't matter. You can do anything you want to do. It's cool.
I feel so sorry.
I mean, I've been preparing for this tournament, my next match after that. I mean, all of...
You might want this. Oh,
thank you. It was a little cold there, man.
Yeah, gotta hydrate for that second round.
Yeah.
Yeah? How you doing?
I'm okay.
Yeah, you doing okay?
Yeah. I mean...
You're very sweaty.
Well, I know. You're pushing
sweaty.
My hair against
you're very
me,
sweaty.
Too. It's kind of...
But I'm very proud of you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks. Go.
Okay, bye.
Go away.
Thank you for the water.
Congratulations and good luck.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Remember when you wrestled at WrestleMania? You got light?
I'm going to die now.
Yeah, don't die after WrestleMania.
What
a way to go.
I'm still trying to stay like really detached because there's a bunch of people around.
I was dating her when she was trying to get into WWE. And she kept getting told no, and no, and no, and no. And I told her, if you want this bad enough, you gotta keep trying, and you can't take no for an answer. And she didn't. And eventually, you know, after making a name for herself all over the world and all these different promotions, she got signed to WWE.
Phoenix Edge here at NXT TakeOver Orlando. You're just out in the arena to watch the Triple Threat Tag Team match. Talk to us about what you guys saw.
It was ridiculous in a good way. We're Revival fans.
Big
and,
time.
DIY fans, you know, all the teams in there. I mean, it was really, really fun. Great action. I mean, and it was fun for us too, because we haven't sat in an audience.
Years. It was actually last time I saw an audience was before I debuted, because I jumped the rail to attack me. And yeah, and this match was incredible. I mean, there was tables smashed, and I mean, every competitor gave it everything they had, and it was so cool to see it that close. We watched NXT so much at home, and to just, yeah, feel the energy of the crowd, there's just nothing like it.
Well, it's a good thing you didn't jump the rail tonight.
I thought about it. I saw Dash Wilder, you know, I was like,
however, when they did show you on the WWE Network, they put a graphic on it that WWE Hall of Famers, Edge, and Beth Phoenix. What do you guys think about that?
I don't know. It still hasn't fully registered yet, I don't think. I think we got down here this week, and I think that's when it started to become real, when people started congratulating you.
Yeah, it's just still, it's like literally, it's not even been 24 hours, so it's still just soaking in, and it's, I mean, it's this elite club. I remember talking to Howard Finkel before it all happened, and he said, you know, now you're in the club, and so it's just, it feels wonderful.
Now you're in.
He did say it like that, yes.
Well, the one thing missing was just Tony Chimmel sitting behind you, but.
but that still happened last night, which.
What was your reaction to that, Edge?
Well, she's so sneaky.
I didn't do anything. I don't know what he's talking about.
So I didn't have any idea. And then I was laughing so hard that I was crying. And I was like, people are going to think I'm crying because she's, you know, paying tribute to me, which I was like, why? She can't do this in her Hall of Fame suit. I'm not standing up. I'm sitting down.
So here's the truth. Adam actually demands an entrance whenever he enters any room,
and
like in the kitchen. I mean, I have to play his music before he gets really ticked off. So the Tony Chimmel thing was like actually by demand.
Well, it was great seeing you guys here over this weekend. And again, congratulations, Beth. And thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us.
Yeah.
It was great. We're going to go watch the rest of the matches.